Hi guys, my name is Anna, and today I'll be showing you how to make plant tissue culture media. Our first step is to add our stir bar to our magnetic stirrer. And then I will add 800 milliliters of distilled water. Then I will add 4.54 grams of MS media from Plant Cell Technology. After, we will add 30 grams of sugar that you can get at a grocery store. Then I will add 1 milliliter of 6-BAP, which is a multiplication hormone. Now be sure to change your micropipette tips. Next, we will add 1 milliliter of PPM, which is a biocide to reduce the risk of contamination. Next, turn off your magnetic stirrer and add the rest of the water to the 1000 milliliter mark. Now, using your pH meter, calibrate the pH to 5.8. Now that the media is finished, I'll show you two different methods of sterilizing the media. If you don't have a laminar flow hood, you must directly pour your media into your tissue culture containers prior to sterilization. To do this, I will add 100 milliliters of my media into each container. Now it is time to add our gelling agent, so I'll add 1/4 teaspoon of agar into each container, which is the equivalent of 8 grams per liter. Now I'll put on our lids, but make sure not to fully close the containers. Now they are ready to put in our pressure cooker. For our second method, I will use a media bottle to sterilize our media, which I will pour directly into pre-sterilized containers under the laminar flow hood.
So you will actually get all your media.
Now it is time to add our gelling agent directly to the media bottle. You can use either 3 grams of gelling gum or 8 grams of agar, but for this example, I will be using 3 grams of gelling gum. And then I will add the autoclave tape on the top when you are finished. The gelling agent will fully dissolve in the pressure cooker, so you don't have to worry about mixing it up. Now it is time to sterilize our media, so I'll add distilled water into our pressure cooker. And then screw on the lid. Now that the lid is on, make sure to evenly tighten it on all sides. And remember, every pressure cooker is different, so make sure to read the instructions on your manual. Now, turn on your pressure cooker and make sure that the valve is open to allow air to escape. Now that steam is coming out, you can close your valve, and then once your pressure cooker reaches 15 PSI, set a timer for 20 minutes. Turn on your laminar flow hood 30 to 60 minutes prior to doing any sterile work, and then wipe down all surfaces using 70% isopropyl alcohol. Now that the pressure is down to zero, open the valve to release any leftover pressure and start unscrewing the lid. If your lid is still stuck on, grab a hammer or a crowbar to help open it. Make sure to use autoclave gloves to remove the media from the pressure cooker. Wait 15 minutes before taking your media out because it is still very hot. Now it is time to pour your media. I have previously sterilized my containers using an autoclave bag, and make sure to spray down all surfaces before you begin pouring. Before you pour your media, make sure to shake your bottle to make sure that everything is properly mixed. If your media has charcoal, make sure you shake it between each pour. When working under a laminar flow hood, make sure to tie all hair back and put on your mask and gloves. Then, spray down all surfaces with 70% isopropyl alcohol. And make sure to also spray your glass dish and wipe it down. Then, take off the seal and spray the container. I'm using a glass bead sterilizer to sterilize my tools, and make sure they cool down before handling your plants. Now it is time to start subculturing. Here, I will be splitting up the plants and removing any dead plant material and roots. And now that the plants are separated, I can add them to the media. This is how easy it is to change the media in your BioCouplers. This is the perfect opportunity to split your plants if needed or remove any dead plant material. This is how you sterilize a plant for tissue culture. I'm using a begonia, so I'll start by cutting off the leaves and cutting around the nodes. Make sure to sterilize your tool before cutting your plant to prevent the spread of diseases. Now I'll make my 10% bleach solution, where I will use 10 milliliters of bleach and 90 milliliters of water. And now I'll add one drop of polysorbate 20. Now I'll add my plants to the solution, and I will shake the jar for 15 minutes. After the 15 minutes are up, I'll pour out my bleach solution and rinse with sterilized distilled water. Now we rinse 3 times, 5 minutes each. Now that the third rinse is done, I'm going to cut the ends of the plants before I add to the media. Today I will show you how to acclimate tissue culture plants to soil. I chose this plant because there was a lot of growth in roots. The first step is to take the plant out of the container and take out any old media from the roots. Now let's take the plants to the sink to give them a rinse. Now let's rinse the plants and make sure to get rid of all of the gel. Now I'll add my soilless media, which is a combination of 50% moss and 50% perlite. It is essential to keep humidity high in the first few weeks using a humidity dome. Then, gradually decrease the humidity so it is at normal house growing conditions. Bye!
Thanks for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested in conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.